Hello and welcome to Social Media SOS, the short show where I answer questions from my community all about social media and about how to build an authentic and visible online business that changes the world. And today I am answering Amy's question, and I know that this is a very common question. Should I focus on my Facebook page or should I focus on my Facebook group? And specifically, Amy asked, what is Facebook's direction with this? So Amy, that's a very good question. And let me start with what Facebook's direction is. So Mark Zuckerberg gave a talk a few months back where he said that in the past, social media were a lot about being on the town square. All the content was public, everybody could see it. There were huge amounts of people. We were on a town square. And where Facebook and social media in general is moving towards is towards a living room setting. Smaller groups, a private setting, and not everybody can see your content. And this is, of course, driven by privacy issues and all the privacy problems that Facebook has had. But Mark Zuckerberg was very clear. He said, we are moving from the town square to the living room. And you can see the Facebook page as the town square because it's public and it's aimed at everyone. And the Facebook group is the living room. It's private. If you have a private group, which I would always recommend. So it's private. It's for a smaller group and it's more intimate setting. So Facebook is definitely putting groups and also messaging at the core of what they do. So that's for Facebook and for Instagram. So if you ask where Facebook is headed, then I would definitely say groups are in the core of what Facebook wants to do, and especially meaningful groups. So Facebook wants your time on Facebook to be meaningful, and they want to create meaningful communities where people go to talk about those topics that are really important to them in their lives. So if you are able to create a meaningful community, a meaningful group, then you are doing exactly what Facebook wants, because that meaningful community gets people to come to Facebook and to spend time there. And that's what Facebook wants. So definitely, strategy-wise, groups are where it's headed and not pages. But I still wanted to address a few reasons why you still want to have a page and why you still want to have a group. So you want both, and also kind of what is the difference between the two. So you definitely need a page because, first of all, you need a page if you want to be able to run ads and if you want to be able to retarget people. And retargeting means you show ads to people that visited your website. And that is a very, very strong way of advertising. I did a separate video about that. So if you want to learn more about that, you can check that out. But if you want to be able to run ads, just having a group is not enough. You need a page. So that's the first reason to have a page. And secondly, and this is something that I kind of underestimated, but it's very important. A page is public. And that means that your content has the potential to go viral and reach millions of people, in theory, if you create the right content that your audience loves. Whereas in a Facebook group, in a private Facebook group, your content is always limited to those people that are inside the Facebook group. So if you want to grow and if you want to make an impact, then a public page that has the potential for your content to go viral and also for people to share the content on your page, the potential is much higher than in a group because people cannot share the content outside the group. So if you want to make a big impact and if you want to see lots of people, if you want to have lots of people see your content, then definitely a page has more potential than a group. And so reason one, ads. Reason two, it's public and you can go viral and people can share your content so you can reach millions. And the third reason is if someone wants to learn more about you before they are ready to join your community, they go to your Facebook page. So if you don't have a Facebook page or if there's nothing there, they might never get to the point where they join your community or where they visit your website. So your Facebook page is your shop window. People go window shopping, they check you out, and if they like you, they follow you or they join your community or whatever the next step is. But if you don't have that page, then you miss the opportunity to tell people about who you are and to have that shop window. So I would definitely still recommend a page. So now onto the group. Why do you need a group? So first of all, because the groups are at the core of where Facebook wants to go, meaningful communities, high privacy in a private environment and so on. So yes, you want it because of the Facebook strategy. That also means that the Facebook algorithm favors content in groups over content on pages. It will show content in groups to more people, relatively speaking, than content on pages. So if you have 200 followers on your page or 200 people in your group, then the percentage of people of those out of those 200 on your page that will see your post will be lower than the percentage of people in your group that will see the same post if you post it both to the page and to the group. So relatively speaking, it's easier to get a good percentage of people seeing the content in a group than on a page, because Facebook prefers groups and because Facebook wants you to pay for ads on your page. So they decrease the reach, so you get pay. That's how they make money, right? Also, the second reason why you want to have a group is because the group has the extra added benefit of being a community. And being part of a community is what people want. It's what drives people. We want to belong. And it is also what will make people return to your group. So if your group is a community and people feel that they fit in, they will return to your group. So they won't only return because of you, but also because of the community. And that's a nice extra reason to have a group, because it will make people come back and consume your content and see what you have to offer. And the third reason is, and this is very important depending on what type of business you have, but a group compared to a page is a safe space. So if you do, like Amy who asked this question, if you're doing weight loss, not everybody might be interested or willing to post on a public page about their weight loss struggles because they don't want their mom or brother or neighbor or whoever, boyfriend, to see that they're struggling with weight loss. But inside a group, they are private, the members of the group are vetted, and they know that they are safe and they can really address what is bothering them and their challenges. So the chance for you to actually get to know your potential customers and get to know what they're really struggling with is much higher in a group than in a on a page, because a group is a safe space. So to summarize, Facebook strategy is definitely on group in the direction of groups. You still need a page because of ads and retargeting, because a page is public and it has the potential to go viral, and because a page is your shop window. And you definitely want a group because of the algorithm benefits, because it's a community, so it gives an extra reason for people to come back to whatever you are offering, and because it's a safe space, so it will be easier to get to know your clients. Now, all of that said, and looking at the algorithm and the reasons to join a group or a page, one other very important thing is that what will work best is the thing that you believe works for you. So if you believe that a page is better for you, if you believe that you can build your dream business on a page, then you can. And if you believe that a group is not fun and you don't like groups and it's a chore, then the group will not be successful. So regardless of what the strategy of Facebook is, regardless of the algorithm, it's also about what drives you and what you find fun and what you feel motivated to do every single day, because you need to show up every single day. So don't only think about those strategic reasons, also think about what motivates you, what you like doing, and what you believe will make you successful. Because if you believe that the page will make you successful, then it will make you successful. So that's my final thought. I hope this was useful. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know in the comments. And if you would like your question to be answered in a social media SOS, then you can join my free group, the Flamingo Lounge, and you can post your question there, and I will answer it in a future show. Thanks very much. Bye.